So I talked to somebody in Texas today, and I know, isn't there some different laws about doing lease options in Texas? Do we need to do something different?
You just don't want to do lease options in Texas. You're just going to do seller financing instead. The numbers
Okay.
and the money all flows the same. You got a price, a down payment, a monthly payment. You know, all that's the same. You're just doing different paperwork and calling that seller financing. Just don't call it a lease option.
Okay, so when we talk to them, is it okay if do we just follow the script or do we actually need to
Yeah.
say
Oh,
something different? Okay.
especially when you're talking to the seller, because we always want to buy from the seller anyway. We're not doing sandwich leases very often. So
Okay.
you're always buying from the seller anyway. And that's what they want to hear, right? We want to talk to the seller in terms of, I'm buying your property. That's all they want to know. Like, okay, I'm buying your property.
Okay. All right, because I just went through the script and just said, because he was like, well, most of all these people just give you cash and let you move on. And so I explained how we did it. I just said, well, we get lease purchase buyers. It's okay to say that, right? In text, like, I'm not doing
That's
something
fine.
wrong or.
No, that's
Okay.
fine because you're just telling the seller, look, this is what we normally do. But now in tech, you don't have to say this part, but in Texas, we might do something else. And
Okay.
in any state, we might do something else. This is what we normally do, work with lease purchase buyers. That doesn't
Okay.
mean you're committing to doing that.
Okay.